Hello. When editing a 3D scene in Cute Design Studio, you view the scene in a 3D editor. In this video, I'll show you how to navigate in the 3D editor view. We'll also take a look at the different functions available in the toolbar, which you can use to transform 3D objects and manipulate the 3D scene. To work in full screen mode, I'll detach the 3D editor view by clicking Detach this group and maximize it. You can navigate the scene in the 3D editor by panning, rotating, and zooming the view. To pan, press Alt and use the middle mouse button to click and drag anywhere in 3D editor to slide the view around. To orbit, press Alt and click and drag anywhere to rotate the view. To zoom, use the mouse wheel or press Alt and right-click anywhere to zoom the view in or out as you drag up or down. You can also zoom and focus on a selected item by clicking on the Fit Selected Object View icon or pressing F. On the upper right corner of 3D Editor, you can see the World Axis Helper, which shows the direction of the world axis in view. To point the camera at the currently selected component in the direction of an axis, click the axis. Clicking the dot will point the camera at the opposite direction of the axis. If no component is selected, the camera is pointed at the world origin. Next, we're going to see how the toolbar can be used to switch between the perspective and orthographic camera modes. You can also choose between global and local orientation, use the edit light, and toggle the grid on and off. Toggle between the perspective and orthographic camera modes by clicking on the toolbar icon or using the keyboard shortcut T. Now that we are viewing the scene in the perspective camera mode, objects that are far from the camera appear smaller than those nearby. In the orthographic camera mode, all objects appear at the same scale irrespective of their distance from the camera. Both of them are freeform camera modes that you can use to orbit around the scene. Toggle between global and local orientation by clicking on the toolbar icon or using the keyboard shortcut Y. Now that we view the scene in global orientation mode, transformation of a selected object is presented with respect to the global space. For example, while the Move tool is selected, selecting this monkey head will show its move gizmo aligned with the axis of global space. Dragging the red arrow of the gizmo moves the object in the global X direction. If we toggle on the local orientation mode, the position of a selected object is shown according to local axis specific to the selected object. For example, selecting the monkey head that has been rotated shows its axis rotated and not aligned with the axis of global space. Dragging the red arrow of the gizmo moves the object in the local X direction in relation to the object. Another useful tool available in a 3D editor is the edit light, which is an extra point light that can be used to illuminate the scene. To switch the edit light on and off, click on the toolbar icon or press U. You may also want to use the grid, which helps you to navigate in a 3D space. To toggle the grid visibility, click on the toolbar icon or use the keyboard shortcut G. Next, we'll take a look at how to use the toolbar to transform objects. To move, rotate, or scale items in the scene, you need to select them first. Click on the selection mode icon to determine how items are selected when you click them in 3D Editor or use the keyboard shortcut Q. In the Select Item mode, a single item is selected for transformations. You can, for example, select this cone and rotate it. In the Select Group mode, the top-level parent of the item is selected. This enables you to move, rotate, or scale a group of items. For example, you can rotate this group consisting of a monkey head and a cone. To rotate items or groups, like we just did, click on the Activate Rotate tool icon or press E. Once you've selected the object, click the axis ring and drag in the direction you want to rotate the item in. To freely rotate the item, click and drag the inner center circle of the gizmo. To move items, click on the Activate Move tool icon or press W. To move items along the axis of the move gizmo, click the axis and drag the item along the axis. To move items on a plane, click the plane handle and drag the item on the plane. To move an item freely in the editor, click and drag the gray handle at the center of the item. To scale items, click on the Activate Scale tool or press R. To adjust the scale across one axis, click and drag the scale handle attached to the axis. To adjust the scale across a plane, click the plane handle and drag the item on the plane. To uniformly scale an item across all axes, click and drag the gray handle at the center of the item. In the past few minutes, we've gone through how to navigate in 3D Editor and how to use the different functions available in the toolbar. Thanks for watching.